Can you tell us about the partnership that you've got with the BFI and the NFTS?
Well, one of the things that we realised, particularly at two levels, one was the craft side of animation. So with the NFTS, we've set up an intense performance animation training course. So that takes about a dozen students, roughly split 50-50 CGI, stop frame. They'll have done a fair chunk of animation, but how do you get them up to what I'd call sort of concert pitch level? You know, they can play a bit of Mozart and Chopin, and they've done the odd performance, but actually, how do you get them up to higher level? And we take them through a series of progressively complex exercises, and they're tutored, a lot of feedback. Lloyd Price is our key tutor there, who's our sort of head of animation. He's trained a lot of our own animators.
This is at the NFTS.
And we actually run it here. Right. We've got a little training room in our old building. One bit's CGI, the other bits are where the model setups are. It's 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, sort of intensive performance animation training. It's really great to see what they can do when they come in and then what they can do when they leave. And they all get pretty good jobs at the end of it. And we've taken, I think, from not the one we've just finished, but the course before, I think we took four, two in stop frame, two in CG. And when you track where they've got to, they all get pretty good jobs. At a sort of higher level. That's really satisfying, actually, to carry on that tradition of really good character animation and what that means. It's a lot of it's about training them how to think about movement and what the character's doing, the motivation. They are our actors, really, so it's a bit like doing actor training with them. Yes, they've then got to translate it into the models, but a lot of it's about, in the same way an actor thinks about motivation. Okay, how do I now express that physically? There's a lot of talent out there, a lot of fantastic talent out there. It's spotting, you know, the best and then giving them opportunities. And I think, you know, the political point I'm going to make is, you know, there is a risk with the cuts that are being made by the government across, you know, say the Arts Council, all sorts of other funding, that the opportunity for that very quite raw talent to express themselves and show themselves and get those opportunities is going to be cut back.